Brought to you by
Eaton Detroit Spring. Proudly made in the USA.
Classic car or muscle car? We want to show you how to restore your automobile and save yourself some money in the process. Sometimes we consult the pros, sometimes we mess up. But just remember, it's never a problem, it's always a project.
Right now on Autorestomod, Jeff heads down to Mustang Central to show how to fit a full floor pan in a Mustang Fastback.
Floor pan for that, National Park Depot.
Honey, what are you doing out there?
Waiting on the next Super Blowout 3-Day Only Mega Sale.
You don't need a sale. You need NPD.
NPD's everyday prices are competitive with most sales, and orders arrive fast from our four strategically located superstores. National Parts Depot has quality parts for Mustang, Camaro, Chevelle, GTO, Firebird, Ford, and Chevy truck. For your free catalog, go online or call toll-free.
Working beats waiting.
Got your floor pan.
Yeah.
How do we get it in there? I've tried going in through the windshield. Doesn't work. I've tried going in through the back glass. Doesn't work.
You have to cut it up into four pieces.
What? I went to Florida to pick this up in the truck from National Parts Depot. Went to National Parts Depot. Said, do you have the floor pan? They said, yes. And so, I have a whole floor pan to go on the car.
Well, it made it easier to carry it all in one piece rather than four sections.
It's not easy to carry as one piece. I've been doing it all afternoon, putting it in the hole by myself. That sounded bad, didn't it?
Yeah.
Anyway, I've had this thing all afternoon trying to get in the car. Tell me what I'm doing wrong.
You have to come in through the doorway.
Are you sure?
Absolutely positive.
So you go in sideways?
Yeah. You have to turn the car upside down.
So we go in sideways through the door. Well, I didn't try. That was the one thing I didn't try. I tried going in flat. That didn't work. So I thought, well, we must not go in through the door. So I guess you have to kind of angle and fold and mutilate and all that to get it in there?
Not the floor pan.
Oh,
You might mutilate your hand. But
that's why I have these on.
Right, yeah, believe it or not, it goes in there. Sure does.
Wow. That's kind of amazing because when these things were assembled, they didn't do it that way. I mean, you know, they basically put the frame rails down on the tracks and then built everything up from basically the floor up. So the fact that you can actually get the floor pan in there that way is pretty amazing, actually. I would have never thought it would have even fit in there after what I experienced with the front and rear glass on it.
I think everybody does the same thing. Yeah, they assume it goes through the windshield. And,
you know. So you go in through the door at an angle. I'm assuming in looking at everything that you probably have to actually go in and take the door off the car?
Yes.
So the door's got to come off the car, at least on one side. And anything else need to come out?
Seats.
Come, this wasn't so heavy. I was going to
That's what I was counting on. You look like you were pretty tired from carrying it, so.
Well, I'm going to put my finger in my hole and go and put this thing over there and talk to the folks about what we got here.
Okay. Very good.
All right. Yep. What we've got here is a floor pan from the guys at National Parts Depot. Now, this is the full floor pan, and if you get one of these from any supplier, it's going to come in truck freight. You're not going to get this floor pan in on a UPS truck. They're just not going to do it. So you have to kind of keep that in your mind when you're looking at doing this kind of stuff. It might be a good idea if you're like us and close to one of their stores and go in and pick the floor pan up because you will be paying truck freight on it. It can be kind of expensive. So if you're doing a full floor pan, I like this one that National Parts Depot sells. It's a really good piece, good thick metal on it. All the bends are correct and in the right spots, and it looks like a jamming good piece. But now, unfortunately for us, the hard part begins. Allan, I had a guy ride in and ask about putting floor pans on a car. And he got varying responses saying the people on the internet were saying to do this. One of my good friends, Kerry, who does a lot of restorations in Australia, Kerry McDonough, said you need to put jack stands on it and all that. What do you recommend? I mean, if a guy's just doing the two-section floor pans rather than doing the entire one like we're doing here, what should he do?
It would depend on the situation. If you really want to get really technical, you could take a level and check your floor where the car is going to be and do some calculations and then set your car up. With a Cooper Fastback, it's not as critical. I recommend that you stack your stands on the front and rear portion of their pinch weld. Go around the car and measure it best you can, okay? Because floors are going to be unlevel to some degree. But basically, by setting it up on the pinch weld, you're eliminating any suspension problems or issues affected by suspension. And in most cases, when you're doing a ground-up restoration, you're not, suspension is gone already because you're taking the car all the way apart. On a convertible, then you would have to do some support bracing on the doorpost area to keep the body from flexing, because with the coupes and the fastbacks, you've got a roof to support your structure. So what I recommend doing at minimum, four stands each end of the pinch welding on the rockers. You can just do a hydraulic jack if you want, and take the weight off the rear leaf springs.
Okay.
You don't have to take the rear end out, but get the weight off the back of the car.
Sure.
And then support your front cross member up at the front of the car.
Yeah, because you and I both know that these cars are pretty bad about wanting to flex right here at this A-pillar.
Right.
This section here is particularly bad with the weight of the engine and everything wanting to drop off.
If your tow boards are in bad shape and you're going to replace your tow boards, then it's real critical to keep your front straight, because the way the frame is on the Mustangs, especially on other cars, you have a separate chassis that bolts
right
to the body,
like
different scenario. But on the Mustang, the tow board is a lot of the support as far as the pivoting of the frame rail. So if you've got a weak tow board, that will change. It doesn't take a lot. So you definitely want to get your front squared up and secured. If you were just doing a floor pan only and you were going to do one side, I really think it's overkill to jack the whole car up. You know, on jack stands, you could have the motor still in it, rear end. There's enough support there already. If you're just going to do the floor pan itself, there's not going to be any loss of rigidity of the body.
Even if you're taking the seat pans out of it, do you think then?
Yeah, especially if you're doing do one side and then go to the other. But like I say, if the tow board's in bad shape, that's the most critical spot, because the tow board is basically the support area on that pivot point. And then off of that, floor supports that go up from the frame rail to the bottom of the floor pans, okay? Yeah. So, but if you're not getting into the tow boards, there's enough there to...
I think we're getting into the tow boards.
Yeah, in this case here. Yeah.
This is one of the few cars I've ever seen that I actually can say it literally looks like Swiss cheese.
Yeah.
So you're going to have to put jack stands on the front of the car. Do you recommend putting them up toward the very front of the car?
Well, basically, all you're doing here is just kind of want to take the weight off of it. So it's not as critical. Like I said, I would do the four corners first, all right, and then measure your car. If it depends on how much your car is there, you want to measure to your wheel housing opening, get them the same on both sides, and then shim your stands to get it level. Do the same thing on the front. You want to start level, okay? And then you want to reference the back frame rails as far back as you can go and the front, and just see if your car is square. And if it's not, when you've got the floor pan removed and the tow board, you've got flexibility. You can bring it back into where it should be without having to, frame machine, unless it's really, really bad. But you'd be amazed how many cars that have not been wrecked, they're just kind of tired. Maybe you've been driving around for a long time with bad floor pans or rusted supports or torque boxes or whatever, and there's a little bit of flex in it. So now's the time to get that straightened out. And then basically what you want to do is just kind of support that front. You don't want to jack the car per se, because then you're putting upward pressure on all this metal up at the front. You're just kind of wanting to just touch it and support it.
Okay. Because I really thought that was really important to talk about, because I know guys, obviously, if people are asking questions on our group on Facebook, we've got an issue that we need to address. So I wanted to go in and ask you about it first, and then we're going to get with Gary and have Gary go ahead and start putting this thing up.
Well, a lot of people don't think about is when you're building a car and you're cutting major panels off. I've seen this on quarter panels a lot. Guys who want to do their own work, glad for them. I encourage it.
Yep.
But they'll jack up the back corner of the car, right? And they're putting a quarter panel on. So they got one side of the car jacked up. They put a quarter panel on, let the car back down. It may or may not look okay. Usually it doesn't. But the problem is that what I call the quarter panel was put under stress, okay? It's basically carrying that twist load. So you may carry on with the car, get it straightened out, and as you start driving, that stress is going to start relieving itself, and it may form up as a tin can situation where it pops in and out, or a bulge or whatever. So the key is to try to keep the heavy points, lighten them up by a little bit of extra pressure, but not enough to affect your level, right. and to keep the car as level as possible, and that'll ensure a better success.
Like with a quarter panel, that can actually cause a problem in fitment on deck lids, sure. and things like that.
Yep.
There's only so much shim adjustment on most of these old cars for deck lids and all,
right.
and that's when I start seeing a lot of shims in the deck lid, I figured there may be a problem somewhere in the chassis on the car.
Right.
So, all right, I'm going to go ahead and let Gary get busy putting this thing up in the air. Appreciate you taking the time to talk to us about that.
Well, you're in good hands.
Who, Gary?
Yeah. Just don't make him mad.
Yeah. Well, yeah, you know. We have success. Now, this took a lot longer than we showed on film. Gary went back and forth on all this. You can go do something else now. Bye.
Bye.
I love you, Gary. Have a great day. This actually took a lot longer than it looks on film. We were here for probably about an hour getting everything lined up and ready to go for putting this stuff in. But the prep work is all. Everything you do on these is all about the prep. So when you're working on this stuff, make sure you get your prep work right, because if you don't, you'll end up with a really funky car that's not actually level. When you're taking a full floor pan out, just like Allan said earlier, you've got to make sure that everything is level. If it's not level, you're going to have a problem, and that problem is going to be a wumpy jaw car. Nobody wants that. Nobody. You'll want to measure everything, brackets, mounting positions on all of the places of the car that are going to have to be brought out when the floor pan comes out, like the braces that are on the back for the side panels. You'll also want to go in and make sure you grab things that are underneath the car as well, like the emergency brake bracket that's on the driver's side of the 67.8 Mustang. Make sure you get measurements of all this stuff, because it'll be a lot easier to put it back when you know exactly where it was supposed to go. All right, Gary's about to do a little bit of plasma cutting. Okay, a couple of little tips here. If you're going to be cutting the floor pan out, make sure when you're cutting, you go to the side that is on the floor pan side. That is, you cut the floor pan, not the panel that you want to keep. If you cut the panel you want to keep, it's just one more thing you have to weld back onto the car. Yeah, I know what you're thinking. He's cutting brake and fuel lines with a plasma cutter. Not really a good idea if your car is brand new. This Hulk has been sitting out in Allen's field for about 20 years. I'm pretty sure that there is absolutely no fuel or brake fluid anywhere in this car, unless someone puts a gas can in the trunk. And there's no good place to set it in the trunk. So, on this car it's not a problem, but when you're working on your own stuff, make darn sure that you go in and pull all of your brake and fuel lines out of the way if you're taking out the full floor pan. And again, if you're doing a full floor pan, you're probably doing a restoration and none of that stuff is in there anyway. But if you're working on a car that's a recent build and you're cutting all that stuff out, you can't do that. You can't go in and cut it out. For one simple reason is there may be residue fuel in that line and you could actually have a nice little hand grenade on your hands. So just remove the lines first and don't do what Gary just did. Gary just did what he did because he could, because as I said, this car's been sitting out in the field for about 20 years. And now we're going to move on after that nice little safety tip. Well, after the plasma cutting comes an air chisel, and you'll be using the air chisel quite a lot on this car. Don't do this with a hammer. This will take you all day with a hammer. Probably the best bet, get yourself some good air and a good air chisel and just go to it like Gary is here. You'll be happy you did that. All right, now what Gary's doing right now is he's not gonna go in and take the fold over out that goes on the outside of the car into the wheel well underneath the car. He's actually gonna leave that on there because it'd be a real pain to put that in and weld it together. So what he's gonna do is he's gonna leave a lip on the inside. He's gonna cut everything down so that he can weld to it. And then he'll go in and flatten that out and make it look really nice. You'll never see it up underneath the car by the way they work on stuff. All right, we're gonna get this floor pan and set it in. This is just a test fit. We wanna make sure we can actually do what we think we can do with putting the pan in through the door. Will it fit? Yes, it will. Right through the door on a fastback. So there you have it. We've got it set in there. We've already told you some of the things we're going to be doing to fix some of the issues. Doing a little bit of a shortcut, but that's okay. So now you know. You can get a full floor pan in through the door of a fastback, as well as a coupe, and especially a convertible. Sweet. Well, Alan's with a customer right now, so he's not going to be able to help me do the closeout, but I wanted to go over a couple things. You can see that our floor pan here looks really, really nice. It laid in nicely, went through the door like it's supposed to. Everything's good to go. Now, there are a few things that they're going to have to take care of that we're not going to be around to show you, and that's fixing that torque box on the driver's side. They're going to use some thick sheet metal to do that, and they obviously have to go in and do the repairs on the tow boards in order to get those right before we can actually fully lay this pan in here. We're probably going to come back and finish that up on the car. We'll come back and show how to do the rest of the installation process on this one and give you some tips and tricks on how to make that work as a full floor pan in a vintage Mustang. Well, that's our show for this week, folks. So do us a favor and come back and watch us then on Autorestomod. Have a great week, folks.
Pretty floors.
Yeah.